Hello students and friends, welcome back to my session on PLC in 21 days. We are on day 11. We'll see the continuation of what we have seen in the yesterday's session. The yesterday session was the same problem, okay, the conveyor control problem. The moment X0 is pressed, then the conveyor belt Y0 must start. After a delay of 1 second, Y1 should start. After a 1 second delay, Y2, after 1 second, Y3, Y4, Y5, like that it starts. If Y5 is on, that means at that time, all 5 will be on. So, Y0 to Y5, 6 outputs will remain in on condition during that 5 seconds. Then after that, Y5 off, after a delay, after 1 second delay, Y4 off, like that it proceeds. Okay, so I'll show you the this we have seen in the yesterday's class actually. So for that, here I used how many timers? Let us check. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 timers I used. Then totally how many steps it has 108 steps actually, plus the end 109 steps it has. Okay, so 11 timer and the 109 steps. Now let me close this one. The revised program inline logic, so it has only this many steps. It has only 72 plus 1 end, 73 steps only alone it has. And more importantly, I used only one timer, not the 11 or 12 timers. So that is the only difference. Okay. This is available with you. Okay. So you can run it and you can see it. Already the inline comparison, this is nothing but the inline comparison. Okay. So between, as long as M0 is on, Y0 is on permanently. So Y0 is on for 150 by 10, 15 seconds. Y1 will be on after 1 second delay. Y1 will be on. Then till 140, it will be on. Right? So between 10 to 1 to 14 seconds, Y1 will be on. Between 2 seconds to 13 seconds, Y2 is on. Between 3 seconds to 12 seconds, Y3, and so on. Finally, the Y5. Between 5th second and 10th second, Wi-Fi is on. Shall we see the simulation? Now I have to trigger X0, device logic X0, force on and off. So you see the counter is also running. Then after 1 second delay, 5 seconds, after the 5th second is over, with the 1 second delay, each and every conveyor will be off. Let me force on again. Force off. Now this remains for 100. Once it reaches 100, slowly in a decreasing order, each conveyor belt will be switching off, will be switched off. Okay, end logic. Let me fuse the program. Let us see physically also. Online. I think it should be 10, if I suppose. Yeah, device manager. Let me check the COM port. COM 8, sorry. So online transfer setup, configure this to COM 8. Connection test, it is successful. Okay, write to PLC. Now the program is written onto the board. Close it. Now let us see the output physically in the board. So this is the PLC board. It is already connected, already fused. This is the input button, this is the reset button, but this time only the one input is sufficient. There are 6 LEDs. One LED is one conveyor. Okay, so now you see, now I'm about to press it. I pressed it now. So conveyor 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then 5 seconds, all 6 will be on. After that, 6 off, 5 off, and so on. So this is how it is functioning. This is how it is functioning. Okay, so now you saw the program. Yesterday's program only, again we are seeing, but with an improved version. Okay, again I repeat, the previous program required 109 steps, this required only 73 steps. So steps wise or memory wise, I will be minimizing. Program wise, we will be minimizing. It has more flexibility. You can play anything you want here. You can play anything you want here. See, this kind of program rarely available in the internet actually, right? So today this program is also available, okay, in as the link in the YouTube video under the description. You can download and you can see it. Thank you.